Kessler, and author of the new book, The Secrets of the FBI, and the idea is to bring out secrets that no one ever heard about, ranging from Marilyn Monroe to Hillary and Vince Foster to how the FBI breaks into homes and offices to plant buggy devices. The idea of this book is that FBI agents develop all kinds of secrets, whether directly because of an investigation or indirectly. For example, the head of the Los Angeles field office of the FBI, just after Marilyn Monroe's death, sent a teletype to headquarters saying that he had lent his personal car to Bobby Kennedy, the Attorney General, to go and see Marilyn Monroe secretly just before her death. And I confirmed with his children that, in fact, on a regular basis, he would lend his car to Bobby to go see Marilyn. So that's an example of, you know, somebody that's not part of an investigation, but sure enough, it's a big secret. Probably the FBI's already been in your apartment by now. You know, when I was first given this material at the FBI, I just couldn't believe it. I thought, am I going to be arrested or are they going to be arrested? Because it was so secret and has never come out before. It turned out that Bob Mueller, the FBI director, actually gave permission to release this information to me for this book, The Secrets of the FBI. One of their people came to my house and said, well, we need to reinstall the bugs. So that was their way of joking around with it. It's basically, any really high-profile case that the FBI takes on will involve bugs and wiretaps that are installed by this secret team called Tactical Operations, or TAC Ops. They're probably doing it right now. It all has to be court-authorized, and there has to be, you know, obviously a good reason. But you never know. You know, they go into yachts, they go into planes, they go into cars and homes, and they'll stage fake yacht parties to get people away from their homes, or they'll offer a free trip or a free dinner, anything to get the people out of the way, so they can install these bugs. The material in the book is how the FBI breaks into homes and offices and even embassies to plant buggy devices without being shot and as burglars. And what they do is, weeks before, they start surveillance of the premises. They see who goes in, who goes out, and then on the night of the burglary, they watch each individual to make sure they don't go back to the premises. If they do, they divert them. They will stage a phony traffic accident, or they'll have a police officer stop them. And that's just one little technique that they use to make sure that they can put in those bugs without any problem. It has to be someone who's about to commit a major crime. And then the idea is to develop the evidence, or already has committed major crimes. For example, with John Gotti, they recorded him saying, you know, we have to off this person, and sure enough, he was killed 3 days later. And they also recorded the induction ceremony of the mafia in Rhode Island, where they prick the finger and they swear allegiance to the mafia and Omerta, meaning silence or else they're going to be killed. That was the first time that the FBI had actually documented that there really was this induction ceremony that the mafia participates in. Well, there are a lot of funny cases, you know, like one was where the FBI thought that there was a dog in this mafia home. Turned out there was also a cat, and when they opened the door, the cat ran out. Well, they had to get the cat, because otherwise that would create suspicion that maybe the FBI had been there. So they went hunting for the cat. All the agents ran around. They said on the walkie-talkie, cat as described, does 9 pounds, gray in color. And then about an hour later, an agent said, cat in custody. So they brought the cat back. But the next morning, they were listening to the bugs, and the mafia people came back, and it turned out that they'd gotten the wrong cat. But these mafia people sort of rationalized it to themselves and figured it was not the FBI, that somehow there was some other reason. But that's a typical story about tech ops.